Hi, I'm back. I'm Amrit Raj, and today we are going to start off with the second session of the chapter control and coordination, guys. So we are running a wonderful series, guys. जैसे कि आप लोगों को पता है, हम एक बहुत ही wonderful series चला रहे हैं, जिसका नाम है उमंग. उसमें हम आपसे topics लेते हैं जो आपको difficult लगते हैं, and we teach it over here on YouTube, guys. And according to you guys, आपको nervous system पढ़ना था from the second chapter, that is control and coordination in biology. Yes, guys. As you would be knowing, I'm Amrit Raj. I take biology over here. In Vedantu, I'm a biology master teacher, guys. Right? हम लोगों ने first chapter, that is life process में से दो topic करे हैं, that is respiration and transportation. Please do watch them if you have not watched it. है ना? It will be very informative and add, you know, value to your, you know, knowledge or studies, whatever. Talking about guys, other subjects में physics, chemistry, mathematics, maybe we are, you know, our teachers have created wonderful, wonderful content which would help you, you know, get extra edge over the other students in your league, guys. So please do watch them and yeah. So as I was telling you, today is my second session on the chapter control and coordination, guys. Okay, sorry, not second session, guys. It's the third session on the chapter control and coordination, right? So yeah, and we are gonna begin with the brain. In the first session, we spoke about plant coordination, how do plants control and coordinate among themselves. In the second session, we just began the discussion on nervous system. That is, how am I able to control my body, right? We discussed that. We studied about neurons and how they help in conduction of impulses or signals in my body. And guys, today we are going to study about the brain. That is brain, hai na? Humare brain ke baare mein hum padhenge aaj. Right guys, so moving forward. So, as you all know, in the last class, I taught you, hai na, ki nervous system consists of three parts, guys. What were the three parts? Nervous system is made up of three parts. Humne kara tha last session, whatever there. It consists of central nervous system and, yes guys, peripheral nervous system. And the third part is autonomous nervous system. We saw ki central nervous system consists of two things, that is brain and spinal cord. That is my central nervous system. When I talk about peripheral nervous system, the peripheral nervous system consists of nerves in my body. Nerves as in, there are wires coming out of my brain, there are wires coming out of my spinal cord, hai na? So these wires which help my brain to connect to all parts of my body, these wires which help my spinal cord to connect to all parts of the body, they form the peripheral nervous system. And guys, lastly, the third part of the nervous system, that is autonomous nervous system, which helps me or all of us to control involuntary organs of our body, involuntary internal organs of our body, right? For example, you know, my dilation or, you know, rest constriction or dilation of my pupils of the eye, constriction and dilation of my blood vessels, that is controlled by autonomous nervous system. We saw autonomous nervous system consists of two parts, that is, yes guys, sympathetic nervous system and parasympathetic nervous system, and both of them are opposite in function to each other. I hope you guys remember this. This was a quick revision, hai na, ki what we did in the last class, and today we are going to start off with the central nervous system and we are going to study the structure of the brain because it's very important, hai na, and we will see. Right guys, so beginning with, where is our brain present, guys? Okay, just a second. Yeah, where is our brain present, guys? Brain is present in the skull in a box called as cranium, guys. Cranium. It is a bony box where my brain is present, hai na? Why? To protect it. Brain is very, very, very complicated and very delicate organ, guys. We need to protect it properly, hai na? Imagine if someone comes and hits me over here, what will happen? I can go mad also, right? So I don't want that to happen. So there's extra protection to my brain, that is cranium. Now, apart from that, my brain is also covered by three protective layers. Guys, what are the three protective layers called as in my brain? There are, you know, my brain is surrounded by three layers. For example, imagine my brain to be a fruit. It is covered by three packings, right? So what are these packings, guys? It is called as meninges. What is it called as? Okay, it is called as meninges. Right, guys? Now, in between these meninges, right, there is a fluid present. What does the fluid do? It prevents my brain from shocks. It absorbs the shock, which whenever it is, my brain experiences some, injury or whatever. It absorbs the shock. What is that fluid present over here called as, guys? Anyone? The fluid present over here is called as cerebrospinal fluid. There's a fluid present in my brain between the, layers covering it, called as cerebrospinal fluid. What does it do? It protects my brain from random shocks. Hello, beta. So as I was telling you, brain is very, very, very delicate and very complex. We need to protect it, properly. That is why, you see, whenever accident happens, we wear helmet. Why do we wear helmet? Because this is a very important part. We don't like anything happens over here, hands or legs, it is manageable. But something happens to your brain, you won't be able to walk, you won't be able to talk, and you won't be able to perform your normal activity. That is why there is additional protection. And natural protection is, guys, meninges, we have the covering, and we have cerebrospinal fluid to protect the brain from the shocks. Very good. So this is outer thing. Cranium, cerebrospinal fluid, and meninges are there to protect my brain. Apart from then, when I study my brain, right, I can divide my brain into three parts. What are the three parts, guys? Forebrain, midbrain, and hindbrain. Whenever I'm studying my brain, I can divide my entire brain into three parts. That is forebrain, midbrain, and hindbrain. Fore matlab upar wala part, mid matlab middle wala part, and the hindbrain means niche wala part. Yeah, simple. Let's move forward, guys. This forebrain, midbrain, and hindbrain, they have further bifurcation. They are made up of further certain components. We'll study about these components individually. Hai na? Very good. Let's move forward now. When we talk about forebrain, na guys, the forebrain consists of three parts. What are the three parts of forebrain? Cerebrum, olfactory lobes, and the third one is diencephalon. We will study about them, each one individually. Talking about cerebrum, guys, what is cerebrum? Cerebrum is the largest part of the brain. And it consists of the sensory areas, the association areas, and the motor areas. Now you'll be like, so what do you mean by sensory area, association area, and motor area? I'll just tell you. For example, cerebrum, as I told you, is the largest part of my brain. It has sensory area. Sensory area means, for example, my sense organs are there. Eye is a sense organ. My nose is a sense organ. My skin is a sense organ. My ears are sense organ. My tongue is a sense organ. So whatever I'm sensing, where does it go to my brain? It goes to this region of my brain. That is sensory area. I'm looking at something, right? Where is it going? It is going to my sensory area. I am touching this pen. Where is it going? It is going to my sensory area. It is like input. Whatever input is coming to my body, where is it going? It is going to sensory area of cerebrum of forebrain. Am I complicating it? No, it's very simple. It's just the way I'm turning. Then talking about this association area. Right, okay, we'll study motor area first, then we'll go to association area, and then it will be easier for you to understand. Now talking about motor area, guys, it is like the output of my body. For example, there's some part of my brain which is saying to talk something. There's a part of my brain which is moving my hand. There's a part of my brain which is making me write. So where is this signal coming from my brain? It is coming from the motor region of the cerebrum of the forebrain. Right, guys? So there is a motor region, there is a sensory region, and there is association region. What is the association region, guys? Whenever input is coming to my body, now my brain relates the information. The brain relates the information, ki what do you know about it? My brain knows ki if I am having a pen, I must be writing with it. And if I am teaching umang, I am teaching brain ka structure, I should be telling. Sensory area means input, association area means processing, and motor area is output. So that is the part of cerebrum. Let me show it to you, guys. Cerebrum over here. Let me show cerebrum to you. This is, guys, cerebrum over here. When you see, Okay guys, this is our brain. Okay, if you see the brain, this largest part of the brain here, you can see the brain is divided into two hemispheres. If you can see guys, the brain is divided into two hemispheres. There's a, you know, gap between them. It is divided into two hemispheres. Now we are going to see one hemisphere. See, this is one hemisphere, and similarly, we have one more hemisphere attached over here. Now, can you see the cerebrum part over here, guys? See, this entire region is the cerebrum region. This entire region is the cerebrum region. Are you able to understand? We will see other parts also, but first now focus on the cerebrum. Starting from here till this part, the pinkish part. Okay, that is what cerebrum. So this cerebrum has sensory area. This cerebrum has association area. This has motor area. Right guys, let's move forward. Let's study it further. Now, the second part of the brain is, guys, olfactory lobes. Second part of the forebrain is olfactory lobes. What do you mean by olfactory lobe means? Guys, olfactory lobe means related to the sensation of smell. Whenever you see olfactory means related to sensation of smell. Right? What is the olfactory lobes part of? Forebrain. Now, the third part of forebrain is, guys, diencephalon. Now, this diencephalon consists of two parts, that is thalamus and hypothalamus. Forebrain consists of three parts, cerebrum, yes guys, olfactory lobes and diencephalon. This diencephalon has two parts. What are the two parts? Thalamus and hypothalamus. Now, what does the thalamus do, guys? Thalamus is an area which coordinates sensory impulses from various sense organs, that is eyes, ears and skin, and relays it to the cerebrum. Are you able to understand? It takes the input to the cerebrum region. It takes the input to the sensory area of the cerebrum region. That is the function of thalamus. When we talk about hypothalamus, guys, hypothalamus is basically control of emotions, hunger, thirst, body temperature and sweating. You know what, guys, if hypothalamus gets damaged, right, people don't know when to stop eating. For example, there was an experiment in, you know, rats mein, they damaged the hypothalamus of a rat, and what happens, it started eating so much, it overate so much that, you know, it died. So that is the function of hypothalamus, not killing you, but the thing is key to control your hunger, to control your thirst, to control your body, to control your emotions. Right guys, so till now we have done forebrain. Forebrain consists of three parts. What are the three parts? Cerebrum, olfactory lobes and diencephalon. Let's move to the second part of the brain, guys, that is the midbrain. When we talk about midbrain, guys, what's the function of midbrain, guys? It conveys sensory information to the cerebrum. It controls the reflex movements of the head, neck and eye. Reflex movements means something is falling in your eye. You suddenly close your eyes, right? If someone is coming to, you know, hit you, you suddenly do this, right? Why? Because of your midbrain. Right, guys? Are you able to understand? Now, you'll be like, sir, thalamus and hypothalamus also were coordinating to sending signals to cerebrum. Midbrain is also sending signals to cerebrum. Why is the same thing done by multiple, you know, regions? Because guys, our body is so complex. One function is performed by many, many, many parts. Right? So it's a very simultaneous functioning of various parts of the brain. Right guys, I hope you understood midbrain. And it helps in convey sensory information to the cerebrum and also reflex movements of the head, neck, and the eye muscles. Right guys, let's move to the third part. That is the hindbrain. Very, very, very important, guys. The third part is the hindbrain. Now, when we talk about hindbrain, it also consists of three parts. What are they? Cerebellum, pons, and medulla oblongata. Right? Now, you need to remember their functions also, guys. Now, when we talk about cerebellum, guys, it helps in maintaining balance while walking, swimming, or cycling. I'm able to walk straight, right? I walk straight, right? I don't walk like this, right? Why? Because of my cerebellum. It helps me to maintain a balance. Right, guys? The second part, that is pons. It helps me to control my breathing. This is my rhythmic breathing, right? I'm breathing in, I'm breathing out, I'm breathing in, I'm breathing out. There's a rhythm, you know, set up over there in my breathing. Why? Because of this pons. If pons get damaged, you know, my breathing will be disturbed. Then guys, talking about the third part, that is medulla oblongata, or we can call it as medulla also. It controls involuntary actions, sneezing, coughing, swallowing, salivation, and vomiting. Okay, you can control semi-incontrollable. You can control your sneezing up to a level. You can control your vomiting also up to a level. You can control your cough also up to a level. Hai na? So what is involved over here? Medulla is involved over here. Right, guys, are you able to follow with me? You know, huh? Guys, this is little bit tough, as in you have to memorize, okay? Little. Right, because obviously we need to memorize something at least, hai na? So what did we study till now? We studied the brain consists of three parts, that is forebrain, midbrain, and hindbrain. The forebrain consists of further three parts, that is cerebrum. That is cerebrum, guys. Over here, what do we have? We have cerebellum. Cerebellum is a part of a hindbrain. Cerebrum is a part of forebrain. Cerebrum has sensory area, motor area, association area. Then we spoke about olfactory lobes, that is, you know, related to sensation of smells. Then finally, the third thing which we saw was diencephalon, that is thalamus and hypothalamus, guys. Thalamus helps in conduction, relay of information. Hypothalamus helps in controlling thirst, hunger, and all those stuff. Then midbrain also, again, sending signals to the cerebrum, hai na? Then moving forward, we saw midbrain, yeah, controls the reflex action of the eyes, neck, and, you know, head region. Then hindbrain, cerebellum for balance, guys. Pons for breathing. Medulla oblongata for sneezing, coughing, swallowing, and salivation and vomiting. Yes, guys, are you with me? Now, there's one more important thing. Students find it very difficult to draw the diagram, right? So let me just help you with the diagram also once, guys. So this is the diagram which, you know, which looks complicated, okay, little complicated. Hana, let's try and draw it in a simpler manner. As I've been telling you guys, okay, it is not about drawing perfectly, but you're drawing something resembling to that. Like this, and brain, you know, you just put S like this, S. Right, guys, and like this, something like this. Yeah? It's not perfect, but yeah, it resembles somewhat the brain. And next thing, guys, what I told you is, you know, important is labeling is very, very, very important. Okay, so we need to label it. What is this, guys? This is cerebrum, hai na? We have cerebellum over here, right? Then we have midbrain over here. Then we have, you know, pituitary. And guys, we have pons. We have medulla. And we have spinal cord. Guys, this should serve the purpose. I know it's not perfect, but yeah, it is representative diagram. Okay, the main thing is you should be able to label them properly. Right, guys? Right? So yeah, you can add to it. You know, you can draw the meninges. You know, you can draw the meninges over here. You know, make it, you know, little complicated. Right now the brain looks a little complicated. So this is how you draw it, okay? And guys, now the functioning we just saw. Let us just see, try and, you know, observe the brain with the help of this thing. Okay, I need to close it, guys. Yeah. Now when we see the brain, guys, if you can see, right, this entire pink region is cerebrum. And can you see the cerebellum over here? That is spinal cord. My brain leads to a tail. Like you can imagine my brain say what is happening. A tail like thing is coming. That is spinal cord, guys. And it leads to spinal cord. Then I have, you know, cerebrum. Now guys, as I told you, cerebrum consists of two hemispheres. These two hemispheres are connected to each other by a muscle called as corpus callosum. By a tissue, not muscle, we can say tissue called as corpus callosum. Okay, it connects the two hemispheres. If you want to see, here these two hemispheres are connected to each other. These two hemispheres are connected to each other by corpus callosum. Now moving forward, guys. Here, right? So this is the pituitary gland, guys, which is also known as the master gland. Okay, now please answer in the comments, why is pituitary gland called as the master gland? Why is pituitary gland called as the master gland, guys? Right, just mention the comments, I will check it. Then yeah, guys, so we have, you know, corpus callosum attaching it, thalamus we have over here, hypothalamus, cerebellum, pons, medulla. Guys, just focus on the location of the pons and medulla. Pons is upper, medulla is niche. Then talking about it, what, spinal cord, we have cerebellum over here, we have midbrain over here in the this region, and we have the cerebrum or the forebrain over this region, right, guys? So yeah, so these are what, you know, are the important things over here in this nervous system thing, right, guys? So we will just see, if possible I will also take a session on reflex action and hormonal control, and we would, you know, try to wrap it up, and then we'll begin the next chapter, that is how does reproduction take place, right, guys? Till then, bye bye. That's it from my side for today's session, and do let us know, okay, how did you like the session, or, you know, what do you want me to incorporate in any further over here in this thing, and if there's anything which you have not understood it, so that I can help you out with this, right, guys? Okay, it was wonderful, you know, staying in touch with you. It is very wonderful to see your comments and all over there. It motivates us to work even harder and, you know, try even harder. And about this chapter, guys, it is a little difficult. You have to memorize certain things, but yeah, trust me, it is like meeting new people. The more you see them, the more you will get familiar to them, and the more you'll be able to remember them, guys. Okay, that's it from my side, guys. I'll see you in the next session. Till then, bye bye and have a good evening. Keep smiling.